joke. New York City, give it to him. He's got a big day, May 2 pill. What you talking about?
And if Richard can provide a 2 pill, can I do this day, May 2 pill? I'll gladly give him the end. I clearly have what can I say? A flea market, and all my equipment will be given away first come first, on the first come first serve basis. How do you like those cookies? And I'll go 10-7 forever.
Well, you know, Mr. Enforcer, I think you're a little late to New York City's ears with that one. In my shop tour video and many videos after that, me demonstrating the ultimate 2-pill, when the confrontation was brought to Dave to bring his best 2-pill to the table, to the camera, he refused. Nobody in New York City wanted to make a move or budge on the 2-pill Texas Star DX399 that I modified, that is in 4 videos, that all of New York City claimed, there's no way that's a 2-pill. So they had to come up and see it for themselves, half of them. Mr. Enforcer, I know you would love to prove to them things that I put past behind them, and I know this makes you feel like you're going to make something out here, redeem yourself, or build some credibility for all the lies, shit you put out here, all the threats, and the only fraud that got exposed out here was you, Doc. I'm going to get back quiet and allow you to try to convince New York City that you're the new man.
Like I said, an amplifier with the same components, doing the same wattage, then I'll keep quiet. Until then, I have not seen a 2-pill I can do with this day made cap. Like I said, I will show the ins and outs of the amplifier. No trickery, no smoke and mirrors. I'm using laboratory-grade equipment, test equipment, and I will go step by step to the various stages and measurements of what the amp consist of, component-wise, its functionality of each individual component, and I will keep it at that, and then I'll give you the final breakdown, the actual transmitting of the unit itself. No drivers, it's a high drive amp, it's a 2-pill, not a 3-pill, like Richard is claiming, but it's all good, because once I open it up to show the insides, you can dismiss all the lies that Richard put forward about me. But it's all good, brother. Because I do forgive him. Like he says, he has a silver tongue. And Satan has the same type of tongue. A master of lies. But I'm not out here to judge the boy. I actually forgive him. Because he knows not what he speaks. So we'll let you be the judge. YouTube audience. 19 audience, channel 19. When you see that Dave made, dead key in it, 300, swinging the 6. You're going to say, Lord have mercy, how does he do it?
Well, Mr. Enforcer, the justified truth here, and the matter of New York City, the way they're looking at it and laughing at you right now, is the sad fact is you might have never seen a 2-pill to do what you're claiming, but they have. In more ways than one, in multiple videos from me. And they've heard it. Now, Richie never contested your 2-pill, your day-made piece of shit. Richie don't really care. Richie never uttered the word 3-pill till you uttered the 3-pill under the word duress and stress in a video gate. So who's the liar here? And where did the word 3-pill originate? Mr. Enforcer, get yourself your 2-pill box. Play your little video game straight. But keep this in mind. When your boy over there, your savior, Dave, was confronted with my 2-pill, don't you think he should have been the first one running to the table with the offer? He ran so far away, it wasn't even funny. And anybody advocating for him out here, shut down right quick when he says, I can't touch that. I'll take it there, and that boy gonna make a monkey out of me. That's right, Nemesis. I'm back in the cut, guys. He's all yours.
On the professional laboratory test equipment that you did possess a 2-pill that either met or exceeded the specifications I'm about to provide such a video. Never heard of one, never saw one. So we can all say, oh yeah, back in the day I had this, that, and that. Forget about what you say. Because like you say, you have a silver tongue. You're a master of lies and deceit. And that's all good, brother. What I provide is truth and justice. That's why you always hear those words after my name, the enforcer. Truth and justice, that's all I provide. I don't mislead. I don't lie to anyone. I have no need to. And I'm not advocating any radio shop or any by name. I couldn't give a crap about Dave. Dave made Fat Boy. Even though they are the best made amplifiers, hand-built, on a one-to-one basis, they're not mass-produced like TNT and these other garbage amps, but it's all good. I'm just saying they're good amps, I'm not saying go and buy one. Let the people out there be the judge for themselves. I'm not here to mislead anyone. I'm not here to put down anyone. But once you see what that Dave made Tupac do, you're going to say, damn it, boy. How did Dave do it? And that's all. I couldn't care if you never bought a Dave made amp. I'm not getting any kickbacks. I'm not getting anything for it. I'm just saying, a man out there by the name of Richard made a claim that he had a Tupac that no one could beat. So I said, oh, yeah? What about this Tupac I have? And his buddy over there, 206. Kept on calling me a liar. The man asked me, what does RMS mean? And I told him about 50 times. And he told me he's a liar, that I'm a liar. This is one of Rich's big supporters. He doesn't know what the words RMS stand for, which I specifically mentioned several time after time what it meant. But Richie, you know, he backs him up, of course. Because they're real good buddies. But the bottom line is, I'm the provider of truth and justice. And you will see it on my video. Alright? On YouTube. It's going to be called The Breakdown of the Dave May 2 Pill. That's it. That's all you got to know. It's going to be called The Breakdown. And you're going to see it in a little color on a YouTube near you. But check it out. It's not there yet. I haven't produced a video yet. But I will. In the near future. Maybe today, maybe tomorrow, when I feel like getting to it, because I got to take the cover off, get a couple of test components ready for the test, and right now I don't feel like doing that. But believe me, that video will be there, and certain individuals are going to feel silly about themselves, and they're going to say, damn it, boy. And I'm going to point out to a few modifications that I did. Alright, I actually improved the amplifier upon receiving it. And I'm going to show the original component and the one I put in there. I don't make the amp, I just make them better. They call me the Forcer around the lower deck. And I just got down.
All right, Mr. Enforcer, in all interest of truth and justice here, I am very sorry, ultimately sorry about your big amount of nervous breakdowns you've had confronting me or battling with me. You started off this scenario here talking about an amplifier. You went on a 6-minute skit with 100 different subjects and threw the whole public off. You are telling them that you've never seen a video or produce a video. Every time you say produce a video of this happening, there's one already out there by me a couple of years old. It's actually multiples on the two pill. Now, you want to convince them that you're a hero, and here you are saying, oh, Richie made a claim he's got a bad two pill, look what I'm going to do here. I mean, you know, if you're saying I made that claim, dude, it's before your time, way before you started keying up on our radio, New Jack. So it's sad to say, it's safe to say that when you're trying to beg and plead New York City for proof to be provided, they've already seen it in the finest form in multiple videos, shown, explained, to watch. They've had multiple challenges, dude. Every big mother who thought he was some kind of radio tech out here said, I got a tube. Okay, bring it over. Let's just put it on camera. We're not changing nothing. I mean, I did this for what? How many months straight? Oh, Mr. Enforcer, you're barking up the wind, bro. You're barking up a dead tree. You want star power, you want notoriety, you want redemption for waging your war out here for Birdman. You started a fight with me that you can't win. There's no way you could win, dude. You've already been ultimately destroyed. You came out here with every storytelling lie in the book about fraud, exposure. I do this radio, that radio, you know, everybody's radio. I did. The only fraud that got exposed out here was you. You got your photos and everything on the internet, and it's destroying you, man. It's destroying you. My manhood, my career, my mic, everything I do. And you know what? I get a kick out of it. New York City, he's all yours.
impossible to produce a 300-watt duct key. Did you not say that, sir?
If I did, it's on video, Gate.
I don't know. Looks like you got mighty quiet there for a second. You turn your lamp off. You don't want to be heard. But I do remember you claiming or saying to 206 that according to your mathematical formulas, there's no way a two-pill with Toshiba 2879s can produce a 300-watt dead key and swinging like I specified. Those are your words. I'm not making these up. Yeah, you claim you had a two-pill Toshiba that did the same power rating, had the same power rating. So you basically contradicted yourself multiple times. You claim you had a two-pill that can do it, and then you say, according to your mathematical calculations, that a two-pill 2879 cannot produce such wattage. So I'm just going to sit back and let the meters show you. And these are professional laboratory-grade meters. These are not MFJ meters. These are not those three little meters you buy at Copper Electronics. All right, these are not $100 meters. This meter is actually more accurate than my bird meter. All right, that's right. It's more accurate, actually several times more accurate than my bird meter. So I'm actually displaying my brand new bird. Not brand new, but it's in mint condition. With slugs. Okay, that's just going to be a reference shot. Then I'm going to pan over to my laboratory quality meter, laboratory grade meter. This way you can't say, well, that's a BS meter, it's not accurate. Oh, it's very accurate, believe me. You don't have to take my word for it. You can do the research yourself. Because I don't own inferior equipment, especially test gear. But I'll let the YouTube audience and Inquiring Minds of 19, let them be the judges. I'm not going to say I know better, I know more, I know less. You gotta let people think for themselves and stop feeding them with propaganda and lies. I'm just a person providing truth and justice the American way. Then I'm back out.
Well, you know, Mr. Enforcer, you know, I have to beg to differ with you over here. I want to get back to an issue. When it comes to boxes being manufactured today, I'm going to say it one time so radio public pay attention in the exact order I stated. When it comes to boxes being manufactured for RF transmissions today, you better know this order and know it in rank. Ameritron, Zitagi, and X-Force. The finest made boxes on U.S. land at the moment with the highest quality ports, I'm sorry, is not from the Dave Made camp or the Fat Boy Junk camp. It's X-Force, dude. You know, I hate to be the one to break it to you, dude, but X-Force is the real deal, okay? Everything down to the quality parts, every component in their units. The lines they brought back from schematics of the original manufacturers. The only thing I have against them is in certain models they have a variable with no three-position switch, and to me that's always going to be a no-no. But inside any event, Mr. Enforcer, whatever it is you feel in the justified truth out here, I just want to enlighten you on something. It's very, very hard to gain New York City's credibility and trust when they witnessed what it is you try to do, and they witnessed what it is they need to witness, hear, and see. The people that meet me, bro, they hear you on their radio, they turn it right off, or they go to another channel. I'm going to be honest with you, it's going to be really, really hard to gain credibility, trust, or gain notoriety with the way you came out, and how you came out, and talking about fraud, exposing truth and justice, yet Richie patiently, at the expense of their ears and their anger, slowly proved any and every word that ever came out your mouth or could ever come out your mouth about me or anything out here is a lie. You have a good day, sir. Am I clear to understand Richie made an asshole out of you from day one? You better believe it and swallow that. I'm back quiet, guys.
Well, the only one that made an ass out of anyone out here is you. You've been making an ass out of yourself for the 4 years you've been on. Alright? I don't make claims that I'm Marion Sade. I don't make claims that I'm a retired captain of the NYPD. Or not retired, what's the word you use? What's the word? Not retired, suspended without pay for the last 15 years, which is highly impossible for any civil servant to be laid off or, what's the word, terminated or suspended. That's an impossible.
Is this a civil servant, a man of law enforcement, fighting to find all the words? This is about to get real funny.
So you could pass that nonsense on to people who don't know any better. But I understand it's just not impressed people. That's fine. I'm not out here to dog you. I'm not out here to badmouth anyone. But you're talking about making an ass of yourself? You're definitely king of that, Richard. See, I really can't 100% prove it's your psychosis talking or if you just drug addiction. And like I said, I'm trying not to put you down, but it is what it is. I'm not out here saying that I'm making claims like you did, that you killed 27 people in the line of duty. You killed three alleged hitmen for the crime family. You ripped out the esophagus, one of the three, on Avenue U in the West 4th Street in Brooklyn. You make these outrageous claims, and you think you have credibility. People laugh at you, Richard. Do you hear me making such outrageous claims? Do you hear me saying I'm married Sade? Do you hear me saying that I'm gonna, I have an account of assets going to be unfrozen in March of 2016 worth $24 million? No, Richard. Listen to yourself. Come on, buddy. I'm just trying to help you, brother. I'm not trying to bash you. But when you say that you make a claim like you have a two-pill that can outdo any two-pill out there, and you made a challenge that Dave made, or to Dave himself, I find that highly laughable. Because no one on this earth, on this planet, is going to believe that. You have zero credibility. All right? Whether you fix amps or not, that's your business. Do you break amps? No, because you don't work on amplifiers. Not that I know of. But I do know for sure you did destroy one radio that I can confirm. But we won't get into that. We won't elaborate. You claim you have 500 radios and you're very successful. There's no power to you. But don't make a claim that there's no two-pill that could do what mine can. And I don't care if it's Dave Made, if it's TNT, if it's Fatboy. The point of the matter is you claim and you made a statement that I'm full of it, that my Dave May cannot produce that type of wattage. So that's where the challenge lies right now. So we can forget about the past. We got to move on and take on better things. And whether your funds exist or not, I really don't care. Because remember, the superior radio and intellect behind this mic is what drives the force out there. They call me 250, the enforcer of truth and justice.
Okay, Mr. Enforcer, once again, you ran on for 5 minutes on 100 issues and throw the whole crowd off. Let me see if I keep it in perspective here. We're going to whack the amps out of here right quick. You say that you don't believe I made a challenge or any challenge like that or that never went down. Well, sir, there's plenty of videos on the topic, with the topic, the challenges, and everything you say. They're a little over 2.5 years old. You should find them all on my Donnie Brasco channel and maybe my first 2 months of Richie Radio, and that'll take care of that issue. Now, listen, getting back to the rest of the issues, man, I'm going to be honest with you. If you did say you married Sade, it wouldn't bother me in the least. I never have. I will soon marry her. I do deeply apologize for me being who I am, my upbringing, my life, my career, the maneuvers and the actions I've perpetrated and executed in my career. I do not lose one blink eye sleep over anybody I killed on the job. I'm going to tell you why. Because I never, ever fired the first bullet. Now, I understand my career really wrecks you, man. The people I'm in who train me with, you know, my nicknames in law enforcement across this globe, who I am in the FBI office, who I am the law enforcement at One Police Plaza. You know, I mean, I understand that, you know, you are intrigued by my life. I think the part of my life that intrigues you is what intrigues most of these people in New York. The fact that I don't know Richie, but I damn sure know members of his family, so let me find out what's up. I think it's my family that intrigues you more, the scumbags that they are. But see, I'm the black sheep. For the reason of being my job, my career, the thing that bothers you the most. Now, as far as speculation about my funds and assets I have, I don't think I ever made a claim about March 2016. I believe the claim was with that date, we were speculating on when the year of the monkey began. And lo and behold, hey, I'm wrong. Sometimes I gotta say I'm wrong, but hey, it started on February 8th. Mr. Enforcer, I'm sorry for you, dude. I really am. I'm really, really sorry for the impact I have on you. I'm sorry for the impact of being real out here. I'm sorry for most of New York City of y'all, like I told you in the beginning. Y'all ain't never ran into a creature like me yet. The reason is because I wasn't little Richie Cappy running around New York. I was an undercover cop going after bigger and better things. Now you've got me, and I'm not the cop no more. There's nothing holding me back. And anybody that got a problem with me like Mr. Enforcer, anytime you're ready to, you know, bring your beef, I'll gladly play the butcher. Little Richie Cappy, back quiet.
Do you feel better, Richard? Do you feel better about yourself now? So what are you going to do, Rich, when I provide that day of truth and justice about that two pill? How are you going to feel? I'm still looking for that challenge. I'm still waiting for you to provide a two pill that can outdo this amp. I'm really waiting for a challenge like that, Richard. A base amp. That's it. It's a little amp. It's not a big amp. And I did hear you. I did hear you make that statement that it's a mobile amp. It's not even a base amp. When you clearly, in the video, see an AC power line cord and an AC fuse and fuse holder right above the AC cord.
I guess he's really hoping and praying that I watched his videos or watched it long enough to see all this.
Intelligent audience out there to decide for themselves. I'm not going to force feed anyone. When they see the truth, they'll recognize it and they'll say, wow, this cat's been telling the truth all along.
This is the reason you just say no to hardcore drugs. A ghost talking, cackling, maniacal, systematic, psychotic guy.